So this is a quick video over here regarding Google Alerts and how you can use this tool to monitor your brand and in an effective way. Most of the times what people do is they just insert some term, but I'm going to show you a couple of combinations of and or situations wherein you can monitor and have effective results as notifications using Google Alerts on your email. Alright, so as you can see right now on my screen, I'm at google.com/alerts. Once you are over here, what you have to simply do is whatever brand name or mention or term or search query or maybe your competitors you want to track or monitor, you can mention over here. So let's say, let's take an example of Flipkart. If I want to have a notification in my email regarding all the promotions which Flipkart might be doing, then what I would do is something like Flipkart. Alright, and I would say show options, and I would say at most once a day as it happens, at most once a week. Now you don't want to go for as it happens because you will be bombarded with emails all the time, because if somebody is even mentioning Flipkart anywhere, what will happen is you will get bombarded with your email, right? So just like this, what you will get is constant emails like Nokia 6 4GB variant announced will be available exclusive on Flipkart, blah 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 blah. Wherever Flipkart is mentioned, you will start getting emails. So you don't want that, right? You want something targeted. So maybe you can do at most once a day, at most once a week. Then you can have sources which might be automatic, or you just want to read some blogs regarding Flipkart whenever something is mentioned regarding Flipkart, or maybe news, web, finance, whatever, right? Video, language, region, you can select any other region as well, or maybe you can just keep it any region which will be like across the globe. How many? Only the best results or all results? Now this is something which we personally think that you should go for all results, because if you have targeted, which I will tell you in a while, you should go for all results, and then you can just change your email address, whatever email address you wish to have for the notification alert, and click on create alert. That's it. Now to make this even more advanced and targeted and super specific, all right, and maybe valuable to you as a notification, what you do is, let's take an example of your competitors. If you want to monitor what your competitors or anywhere on internet, whenever something related to your competitor is being mentioned on maybe a blog, maybe in the news, maybe in the magazines, maybe in the forums, maybe in the videos, wherever, you want to track that and you want to get notified in your email, what you do is you can do something like competitor A, right? Obviously this would be your competitor name, and you can create an alert. To make it even more aggressive, to make it even more valuable to you, what you do is put double quotes besides it, right? Now what will happen is only this exact term whenever it is mentioned would be written. So let's say if we type, so let me just give you an example. Let's say if Samsung is my competitor. Now if I'm typing Samsung, then whenever Samsung is mentioned everywhere, it would be like notifications for me. But I want to have something like Samsung phone. Whenever Samsung phone is mentioned, I want to be notified. But now if you just keep it like this without any double quotes and with a space, whenever something wherein just the phone or Samsung, just that much is mentioned, you will get notification. What you want is the exact term. So you keep this into double quotes. So whenever you do this, now you will only get alerts whenever Samsung phone altogether is being mentioned. All right, Samsung phone. So whenever you see Samsung phone, you will be able to get the notification. You won't get some random. So now this is a little bit more narrowish. This is more specific. On top of that, let's say you want to have notifications wherein if somebody is talking about Samsung phone or maybe Samsung TV, all right, maybe Samsung TV. Even if it is or, then also it will work. So whenever now there would be Samsung phone or Samsung TV, you would start getting, so see here it is Samsung TV or Samsung phone. So you'll start getting alerts for this. Or let's say you want to go very, very specific, means you only want to have results wherein Samsung phone and Samsung TV both are mentioned. So you can do an and condition. And now only Samsung phone and Samsung TV, wherever in the article it would be mentioned, only then you will be getting some other alerts. This is how you can be super specific, and this will give you a lot of good results in terms of notifications. So this is how you can track your competitors' mentions, or you can just have your branding. So let's suppose if we at Digiperform wants to track hashtag Ask Digiperform, or whenever somebody is typing at Ask Digiperform, what we do is, let's say we'll go for inverted double quotes, we'll go for Ask Digiperform, or maybe a couple of people might be writing with a space, or we want to track hashtag Ask Digiperform, or maybe a couple of people might write something like space between this. There might be spelling errors and things like that. Or we also want to track Digi Talks by Digiperform, inverted comma, inverted double quotes, and we also want double quotes hashtag or without hashtag Digitalks by Digiperform. Right now, any of these alerts, I would start getting emails over here, right? So wherever it is. So I'll click on show options. I would go into this at most once a day. Sources would be automatic, everything I want. And English, region, let's say any region. All results and deliver to this. Create alert. Now onwards, I'll start getting emails related to this. This is how you can monitor your brand or your terms, search query, competitors, and etc. etc. So I hope this was helpful, guys. If it was, let us know in the comments below. And what was the best part out of this video? We would be happy to hear from you. I'll see you in some another video. Till then, take it, bye-bye. And as always, guys, stay awesome, God bless, and subscribe.
What new things would you learn in 2018? Let us know, and we would try to help you and Digiperform with digital marketing knowledge every single day in 2018. And do let us know in the comments below. Once again, do subscribe to us so that you don't miss out on any particular video in 2018. And I look forward to see you in this particular video.